Thank you, everyone, for visiting our presentation. I know it's quite hard and complex to do a second day. I hope it will be interesting for us. So my name is Alexei, and my friend Andrei. Both of us are from Russia. When we are not drinking vodka, we are doing life-ready development. And today, we want to share our experience of using Life-Ray as a BPMS system, as a server for executing business processes. And not only executing, but also for modeling. I will be responsible for first part. I will show how it works from business perspective, how it may be used. And Andrei will speak more about technical details, how we migrated everything from 6.2, what problems we meet, how we resolve them, and so on. And also he will do some small technical demo. So Life-Ray and workflows. Actually, Life-Ray already have support for workflows. All of us know it's a Kaleo workflow engine. And it's used in Life-Ray mostly for approval of content before publishing. So it's possible to upload some workflow definition and when define for which asset entry type, which process will be used for approval. Kaleo has some, I think, very good advantages. First of all, it's a simple. It's very simple. Also, it's ideally... It was designed for content approval, so it's very easy to do a processes what will approve content. And Kaleo, since it's written by Life-Ray, it's closely integrated in the portal and fully reuse whole functionality like notification and so on, what provided by a portal. So if you need just to approve content in your portal, Kaleo more than enough. But it has some disadvantages. It's simple, but sometimes it's too simple. Again, if you need to put into approval just few steps between different people, it's more than okay. But if you need to do something more complex with sub-processes, with parallel execution, okay, parallel execution supported in Kaleo, but with sub-processes, with timers and many other stuff, it will be much more complex to do with Kaleo. It's Life-Ray specific. So if you want to build a complex BPM system and you need analytic to write business processes, models for you, this analytic should understand Kaleo. You cannot, Kaleo used own language, own XML to describe processes, so you should really go deep into Kaleo to do anything with it. Another disadvantage, online editor available only for enterprise edition. So in enterprise edition, you can draw your process with online editor, but if you are using community edition, you should write your business process by hand in XML file. And also for simple things, it's enough, but for complex things, it may be very complex. Actually, what we will speak now, it's not something new. We already have integration between Life-Ray and Activity for version 6.1, 6.2. Version for 6.2 even now available in Marketplace. So during our work we did last month, we mostly did migration. So and we have two issues, two ways for migration. First, we had to migrate all our stuff from Life-Ray 6.2 to 7.0 DXP. And it's exactly what Andrei will speak a lot about, because you know, Life-Ray 7, in terms of architecture, it's like a new product. And if you like to move something, you should sometimes just rewrite it. And our migration path was related to fact what the core team of Activity moved out from Alfresco. Alfresco is a company who has sponsorship for Activity, and we organized own new project, Flowable. So next version of BPMN engine we are using in our job, Activity, is called Flowable 6. So we also have to migrate all our integrations, what we did, from Activity to Flowable. By the way, I am afraid I forgot to add a slide. For somebody who don't know, Activity and Flowable is a workflow engine based on BPMN. It's Java, it's open source. widely used in, by Alfresco, and it allows you to implement really complex business processes and execute them. So if compare what we have with Flowable instead of Kalea, we have some advantages. First, workflow engine based on BPMN standard. It's standard notation to describe business processes. So if you are starting to do some system and you invited analytics to draw your process, we don't need to study new notation or to understand specific of Kaleo, you just use standard notation. Even you can draw your processes in any BPMN editor, what widely available, but we have, I will speak later, we have own editors as well. Since it's supported BPMN, it has many advanced elements what Kaleo doesn't have. For example, sub-processes. If you have a complex process like approval for credit request in bank, it's something from our experience we had. You cannot do it in one diagram because it's a really complex process what took into different parts of bank to pay attention of many people. So you need to use sub-processes. In BPMN standard it's possible and you can use it as well in LiveRay. Very nice features like timer events, for example. On any user task you can put through notation, so it doesn't require any development. You can put on user task, task performed by some user timer, and say, okay, this task should be performed in one day. And if it's not performed, process start go by some hour way. So you can react if somewhere task stopped for too long time. We implemented, actually we integrated Activity Online Editor, Flowable Online Editor into LiveRay as a portlet. So you can use Online Editor and you can use it in both in Community Edition and DXP. As well as it has Eclipse-based editor, so you can draw your process in an Eclipse. And we implemented task form support, so for each user task you can say what LiveRay forms should be used to fill data. And all data what filled by user on the web step will be available in a process context, so you will able to use it in next steps, or you can route your process depending from what user entered and so on. So this is unfortunately for last point, since we are reusing standard LiveRay UI functionality, but standard LiveRay UI functionality doesn't support this feature like task form support. Oop. How to? Ah, this feature. So we had to implement own portlet to work with tasks. So when you work with tasks, you can use standard LiveRay UI or our portlet, and when you will able to fill tasks on the user steps. Our integration distribution contains several bundles. Andrei will show them, but in general it consists from three parts. First is a Flowable workflow execution integration. We just get Kaleo workflow engine, put it out from LiveRay, and implement the same interface with using Flowable. So we can just deploy it instead of Kaleo, and fully reuse BPMN processes for approval for anything we need. Online modeler allow you model your processes online and deploy, and task forms. It's support for specific forms in user tasks. Everything is implemented as OSGI bundle. It was part of our migration from 6.2 to 7, and I hope it will be available in Marketplace in October because we mostly finishing our testing and we'll put it in the marketplace. Let me show a little bit how it looks like. Okay. Where is browser? I'm afraid it's too small. So this is LiveRay. This is LiveRay Community Edition. And after deploying all our bundles, we will have additional element in control panel, BPM and process editor. I already put as example one of process we developed for one of the bank for to process credit requests, and just to understand the complexity, how complex it may be. Let's go into credit card process. It has 6 sub-processes. We can show look diagram, okay, in preview mode. Or even we can launch our online editor. Okay, let's do it now a little bit smaller. So this is a whole process, to process credit card request. It contains several steps. Let me just do some like. First, we should enter a request form, go to underwriting department, when go to security department, when go to another underwriting department. If request was approved, you should generate documents, put information into the internal bank system, and so on and so on. Everything of this is possible to do in just via process define it in a model. We can see any of sub-processes. So as I said, we support sub-processes, and we'll go to like underwriting 2. Underwriting 2 process contains, let's edit it again. It has different steps, like it performs scoring if using external server. We are used Fico services to get scoring and so on. And when it has user task, it has automatical task to connect some our system and so on. Scoring also contains sub-processes and so on, go deep. So again, if you need just approve web content, Kaleo is enough. If you need something complex, Kaleo not enough to do complex things, and you can do it with BPM annotation and in online editor. Let's go. It's possible to create new model. We can click just new model. Go to online editor and start to create process by drag and drop. So we can define user task to put exclusive, put and let's change it from to script task. So here we can execute some script depending from what user choose. Here we can put chooses approve. Same as in Kaleo, we can use here script, like Groovy script, to be executed with using a whole LifeRay IP available. So here we can, for example, call a service to change status of asset, to change it to approved or to deny it. And process will be finished. So it's quite easy to create new process with editor, just a few clicks and you have a simple process. When process is ready, we can save it. Go back, and after it's ready, we can just say deploy. It's failed to complete, I think, because I didn't fool it with, for example, who should respond to the task, or I didn't fill scripts. But you can deploy it directly from editor, and after it, you can assign your assets to be approved by this process. And actually, how we did with credit conveyor, what we implemented for bank, we just implemented our credit card request and asset and assigned, depending from product, from credit card or overdraft or anything else, we assigned different processes for approval. What's time? Oh, too little time. Just last thing, after processes started, same UI available in my workflow tasks, same LifeRay UI may be used to work with these processes. This is all from how to define process, and I will give words to my friend, to Andrei, how to start slideshow. To continue.
Let's return okay. Back.
Yes.
Okay. Hello, everybody. My name is Andrei, and I'm head of integration and middleware department in MDiv. Thanks, Alexey. The first part was about business aspects of business processes. And I'm going to tell you about a more boring thing. It's about technical aspects, and it's about the history, how we have done the migration of from 6.2 version of LifeRay to 7. Migration, I think the most of developers and testers and analytics agrees that it is a headache, especially when we have to migrate from different directions. In this case, we have to migrate from LifeRay 6 to LifeRay 7. We have to migrate from Activity one version to Flowable, completely new project. Not completely new, based on Activity, but it's fairly new. We have something under the hood. It's different tasks about build tools, about Spring and OSGI, and etc. etc. LifeRay 7 is OSGI, and OSGI has advantages, disadvantages, but when Alexey dropped me a mail, it was the end of December in 2016, and he asked to start the migration from Activity to Flowable and from LifeRay 6 to LifeRay 7. And we have experience in integration products. It's JBoss Fuse. It's Service Mix, Apache Service Mix, and Apache Carafe. And first thing that occurred to me, it was Blueprint. We initially tried to do all things with Blueprint because a lot of Spring stuff was in LifeRay, a lot of Spring stuff was in Activity, and Blueprint fits very well. We tried for probably several days to integrate Apache Arise, and we succeed in deployment. We could start bundles, but unfortunately we had two contexts different. And then we start some investigation and find out that LifeRay refused from using Blueprint and appropriate ticket in Jira. So we switched to declarative services. What was done with all Spring stuff? We proceed our investigations, find out that LifeRay still use the Spring, and it all about aspects. It's all about transactions. And Liferay has a separate tool to use Spring in custom bundles. It's Spring OSGI extender. We thought, why don't we use this? And we combined Spring and declarative services, and it's all about dependency management and dependency injection. So, what about Flowable? Flowable migrated from Activity. It was forked from 5.22 version, and of course, there are a lot of things to be done, and it was done because of code refactoring. It's package names. It's something changed from version to version, and we have to do big refactoring. We have to improve MyBuddies mappers because Flowable based on MyBuddies. We have to double check custom fixes. We added possibility to invoke custom code and service tasks. We added some custom parsers to make life easier with Liferay. And in this slide, you could see what was. It was a simple web archive. And all third-party bundles was put inside lib folder. And now we have separate bundles. It's our custom, a list of our custom bundles. In the next slide, you could see the detailed description what each bundle do. The first bundle, it's an entry point. It's a message listener implemented here. We have API bundle. We have third bundle. It's an all implemented code for communication with Flowable. Some util bundle, bundle for Groovy scripting because we had the class loader issue, and we added this bundle to do something with it. And a separate bundle for workflow tasks. I will show you a little bit later about tasks. So this is some overview of third-party bundles that I used to deploy this integration. And this slide regarding forms. What we have done? We have done integration of Liferay forms with user tasks of Flowable. You could map Liferay form with user tasks during the designing of process, and then you will have a separate UI. We forked Portlet my tasks, and you could put in some values in a form, and then after submit, all values will be available in workflow context. You could use it somehow. There's some words about current state. We have Flowable 6.1.2 integrated with like Liferay Community Edition and DXP. We could deploy and run deployment processes. We have features that made life with Liferay easy. We had the possibility to use forms. We have transactions. We have possible to invoke custom OSGI services, and we have possibility to use util classes from script tasks. There is something about next steps. I think it's old version of presentation. We have some more steps. The first Alexey told about release. We are going to release this in a month or so. We would like to add REST support. We would like to use workflow as asset, workflow process as an asset. I think there is one more item.
Yeah.
I don't remember. Demo. Okay, for the demo. How could I switch? How could I switch?
Escape
to browser view.
I don't know.
Strange.
Probably is it you have mirror?
Mirror. You mean here?
No, I don't know. We can switch unfortunately to browser to show demo. No, we already exit from full screen, but it's not mirrored by somebody.
Yes.
2 minutes left.
Okay. I will do my best to. Okay. Now we have fresh library. I'm going to show you how to deploy our custom code and how to start the simple process. First of all, what we have to do is to switch off Kaleo. To do this, we have to go to App Manager. In this
by search, I can use search as well.
Here is Kaleo workflow engine. We just deactivated. Then.
And you can check what now we don't have workflow functionality now. We can't see workflow task and so on.
We have prepared bundles. I divided it into four folders. First of all, we have to deploy some third-party bundles. Just copy and paste it into deploy folder. Now, let me check this. Okay, started. We have the next, it's my bodies bundle. It's separated. Okay, it has started. Then go to Flowable. It's all about Flowable engine itself. It's time to finish. And there is one step. Yeah, it's our bundles. Will be less than a minute. So I believe all required stuff was deployed, and I'll switch to control panel, and we have a configuration. Just refresh the page, and we have a workflow definition here. We could add custom processes and start it, but unfortunately, I have no time to demonstrate it.
Anyway, if somebody have questions, we can show and discuss it after this presentation.
Thank you, guys, and sorry.